Hare Krishna. Karma is not like a mysterious contagious disease. It is logical, not diabolical. When we may come to know about the principle of karma, how we are accountable for our actions, and we also understand that we have to be responsible, we have to be cautious about what kind of actions we do. Sometimes this understanding can lead to associated notions that may be not accurate. So one such notion is that if we associate with people, we will get their karma. And then we may, by this notion, start treating people like untouchables. We may become very discriminatory, very judgmental, very condescending, very cloistered and closed. Now we have to understand that while it is possible that karma may come to us in various ways, but karma is not like a mysterious contagious disease that can come upon us in any way. Say there are some diseases which, just if a person opens their mouth, the germs come in their mouth and they come into us and we get infected. So we shouldn't start looking at others as less than human. Now, every soul, every being is a part of God, and every soul deserves dignity because they are parts of God. If the philosophy of karma makes us stop treating each other with dignity and it erodes our humanity, then we are defeating the purpose of the philosophy. The Bhagavad-Gita tells us that those who are self-realized, they see everyone equally. Atma upam yena sarvatra samam pashyati arjuna sukham va yadi va dukham sayogi paramo mataha. In the Bhagavad-Gita, in the 6th chapter, Krishna tells Arjuna in 6.32 that those people who can see the true equality of all living beings by understanding that just as I am a soul, they are souls. So such people, they actually can understand that the same thing that caused me happiness and distress cause others also happiness and distress. And thus, there's a profound level of empathy that develops when we become spiritually advanced. And it is this empathy that is required by our spiritual growth, by our spiritual knowledge, not judgmentality and untouchability. So just as if somebody looked down upon us, somebody condemned us for things which we didn't even know are wrong, and for some wrong which we haven't, maybe we haven't done also. So then we would feel alienated. The same applies to others. We need to be kind, cordial, and if we are intending to do good and we are trying our best to do good in a proper way, then we are focused on being Krishna conscious. How can I best serve Krishna in this situation? Not karma conscious. Oh, I have to avoid karma. How can I avoid karma? How can I avoid bad karma? That's not our purpose. Our purpose is, how can I best serve Krishna? And ultimately, karma is complicated to understand. In 4.17, it is said that gahana karmano gati, that it is very difficult to understand the workings of karma. Kim karma kim karmeti kavayopyatra mohitaha. And even the wise people are bewildered about what is karma and what is akarma. So we shouldn't think that by our judgmentality, by our condescension, we actually are acting with a foolproof understanding of karma. Karmano yapi bodhavyam, bodhavyam cha vikarmana, akarmanascha bodhavyam gahana karmano gati. So it is required to contemplate very seriously to understand karma. And ultimately, karma is not diabolical, out to get us for some minor infraction. It's not like a malicious germ that even by an accidental contact will kill us. Karma is logical. If we do wrong, we get wrong. If we do right, we get right. And ultimately, if we are working for the supremely right cause, the right cause of serving Krishna, then we will always be safe, we will always be protected. We have that intent of serving Krishna. In 18.66, he assures that aham tvam sarva papebhyo mokshayishyami ma shuchaha. So rather than being living in fear of karma, we can live with faith in Krishna and serve him in a way that can attract other people towards him through us and not alienate them from him through us. Thank you. Hare Krishna.